Hi everybody, this is Jody with Jody's Kitchen. Today would have been my parents' 45th anniversary, and my dad, he passed away 6 months ago. So we're trying to do something special for mom. So what we're going to do is we are going to fry some chicken. We're going to fry up some potato wedges. I'm going to make an apple coleslaw. I already made a blackberry crumble top pie. And then I'm going to make a banana cream pie. And I'll show you how to do that one. And let's see. I know I'm missing something. But hey, we'll throw it in there. And I'll use this intro for the rest of them. But today I've also got my sister helping me. Her name is Jamie. According to my granddaughter, her name is Mimi. So we call her Mimi quite often. So I hope you guys enjoy, and everything is organic. Just love, 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 love this food. So, and we'll be cooking outside today. Yay! That way I don't smell at my house. And no smoke, no odors. That's good for me. It seems to be looking up to be a really nice day. So we'll be doing that out on the deck. So I hope you guys enjoy, and I'll see you in a moment. Okay, what we're going to do is we're going to make the breading for our chicken. And what I did is I've got, you know, just like a quarter of my loaf left over. I'll just pinch it apart and put in my little food processor. Love this thing. Does everything.
Easy to clean. And, very effective.
Oh yeah, no doubt. Okay. And you can pick these up at like Walmart for just like $5.
Yeah, so they're cheap.
Okay. Jamie's gonna get our fryer started. And what I like to do, because we are gonna have quite a bit, I've got like 3 chicken fryers that we're gonna be doing. I need a lot of breading. So I'm going to go ahead and just take the rest of this loaf. And, you know, this loaf is about a week old, actually. Yeah, it is. Tomorrow would be a week old. And it's kind of dried a little, pretty firm. But you know what? That's okay. That's perfect for what we're doing. And again, you know, it's all organic. And this is a great way to use, you know, bread that might be going bad. You can do this and put it in a Ziploc, put it in the freezer, and you can use it some other time. Or, you know, you can cut them into chunks, 1-inch cubes, put them in the bag, and you can use it for dressing some other time. So I'm going to keep going on this. And it's not. There we go. Powder, garlic powder, really, really good. Mm-hmm. What I got here is just like 1/8 of a cup. You know, it's about the size of a tablespoon, I think.
A big tablespoon.
Okay. And there's 1/8 of a cup. Need that much pepper, but whoa. I don't know. Our family likes a lot of pepper. I think it does a lot of seasoning. And then I don't want to overdo it. Oh, you got me some onion powder. All right.
Onion powder is key.
I'm going to do 1/8 of a cup in there.
Oh, that's good.
There you go. Okay. Okay. Just mix this all up. And Jamie, you use just eggs, don't you?
Yes. Nothing else.
Just eggs. Okay.
Just eggs.
Just be glad that my granddaughter, Journeybug,
oh,
is not here breaking eggs.
Can I use this?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, she's totally funny. She doesn't just crack an egg, she pulverizes it.
Yeah, oh gosh, oh my gosh. She likes to cook with me all the time over at my house. And she stands up on a step stool and watches me do everything, even around the stove. Well, one day I thought I had this brilliant idea that I was going to try and teach her how to crack an egg. Well, she had just turned 2 when this happened, okay? And she is so smart. I mean, she's just amazing. She just really is. But I showed her how to crack the egg, open it up, and then, you know, throw it away.
Huh? Only half the...
Oh, okay. Well, I just keep cracking, you know? Anyways, so I gave her the egg, and I said, okay, now crack it. She takes that egg, and she goes, whoop, poof, right into the skillet. shell and all. I was like, oh my gosh.
And she was having fun doing it too.
Oh yeah.
And before you realized it, she had grabbed another one.
She had grabbed another one and started to do it, and I caught it in time, and I was like, okay, we'll try next year.
I'm putting all our chicken out here in a pan and separate it by cut. Got our legs, our thighs, our wings, and our breasts. Okay, and then let's see, you've already put in some peanut oil in the fryer.
Yep.
And we're going to be doing this outside so that I don't stink up or smoke up my house.
Yep.
I'm real particular about that.
Yeah. Well,
you know,
I am.
I don't like the smell of onion in my house. It's, to me, it smells like body odor.
Yeah.
You know, I don't know. I don't want somebody walking in my house and going, oh my gosh, what's that smell?
I know.
Hello. There's my sister. Hello. Okay, and what we have here is we've got our chicken in the big pan. We've got some egg and we've got our breading. And what we're going to do is we're going to bread these up and set them off to the side, probably back in the same pan. That way we can just grab them all at once. Good point Jamie made is if we bread them beforehand, they'll go into the fryer at the same time. Otherwise, they will not be done at the same time. So that's what we're going to do. And since I've got it sectioned off, you know, the wings, the legs, the thighs, the breasts, then we'll do those, you know.
Sure.
Prospective partners.
Yep.
What we have over here is our fryer, and it's a big, huge it's a big turkey fryer.
Butterball.
We've filled it up with some peanut oil. And
why peanut oil?
Huh?
Why peanut oil?
Well, peanut oil, actually, when you're trying to go organic, is probably the best thing to use. Just make sure that you're not using something that has one of those anti-foaming agents in it. I mean, because that's the same stuff that goes in the pink slime.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Pink slime, where's the pink slime go?
Chicken nuggets.
Yep.
Lovely.
The same thing you're feeding your children.
At Mickey D's. And what I'm going to do is put it in the egg. You just shoo this thing away. I can't stand that.
Yeah.
And then bread our chicken. We're gonna start with our breasts, because those take the absolute longest. Okay, and what I'm gonna do is take this one, shake it off a little bit. Put it back in the pan like that. And I use 2 different tongs, that way it doesn't get really super gummed up. Okay, we're gonna test and see if these are okay. Really hate working with hot oil.
I know. I do too. It just hooks right there, Joe.
Yeah, I know. It's mine. Okay.
Well, you said you only worked with it a couple of times or one
yeah.
time.
Okay, now I'm going to just test to see if it is mm-hmm. done. And I'm going to go down through the center. Ooh. Oh, yeah.
Done?
It looks cool. Like it. Yeah, so 20 minutes for the
press.
Go ahead and grab these out of here. Put them in another pan. Oh, those look good. Okay, and then what I'll do, go ahead and grab some more and put those in there. For another 20 minutes.
I want a Sunday kind of love, a love to last past Saturday night, and I'd like to know it's more than love at first sight. And I want a Sunday on the square. Can't seem to find somebody, someone to care. And I'm on a lonely road that leads to nowhere. I need a Sunday.